Hi guys, my name is Bifo from RFN. Look at that beautiful sunrise. Or is it a sunset? I can never tell. They give you no compass, so you can't tell which way is east, which way is west, etc., etc. But anyway, not important. Welcome back to episode 2 of Loot Drops. Sorry this took so long to get out. Last week has been a little bit crazy. I've been leveling an alt. I've been trying to get to grips with university again, and I've been trying to make sure that my real life is not so crazy. Not to mention, in the background, there are a few YouTube things going on. I'm getting some improvements to my setup over the next few weeks, so you can look forward to that. That's going to be particularly important for you guys who want to watch me stream. I took a huge hiatus from streaming, so expect that back at some point very soon. I should, at a very soon point, be doing the Peasant Guard Raid Night streams every Tuesday, so that'll be nice. And the reason that I can finally do that is because I'll be able to capture our Skype audio, because the setup includes a whole new rig, which is going to be epic. Oh my gosh, I'm really looking forward to that. But anyway, not important. Just letting you guys know all about that kind of stuff. The thing I really want to let you know about, though, in this video in particular, is more about loot. In particular, what I think is probably the best fusion rifle in the game at this current point at Legendary tier, if you're looking at the new Vanguard stock. In fact, I'd say this is just one of the best fusion rifles. It is plug 1.1. This is my Bungie Christmas present that I got. And my god, this thing is amazing. Now, I need to explain a few things about fusion rifles first and talk about these stats. Now, element is completely relevant here. This will max out at 3 through 1 attack, as you know. But the big three things that will always matter for a fusion rifle are as follows: charge rate, impact, and stability. Those are the three most important statistics on any fusion rifle, as far as I'm concerned. If you have a fusion rifle that has a higher charge rate, as you can see with Final Rest, it's going to charge in less time. Keep that in mind. The same can also be seen with Murmur. If you put that onto its arc setting, it's going to charge a lot faster. So, yeah, having a very high charge rate is good, but I feel as though there is even more potential when there is a huge stat increase in stability and impact. Now, the reason is because of the way the fusion rifle works. You can charge these things around corners, which means that you can pop out and deliver your deadly blow just as the fusion rifle is finishing its spin up in the chamber. The way that this basically manufactures engagements, it sort of pushes them into this mid-range zone, and that is why I feel that stability is so important, because you have to land all of your shots at this kind of strange range where you're trying to push away shotgun users, but at the same time you're competing with auto rifles. You need to make sure that deadly burst gets on target. Now, some fusion rifles most certainly do not have a problem with that. I know Light of the Abyss most certainly does not at all, but this I feel is even better. Now, I'm not sure if I actually have it. I believe this is on another alt at some point. I'll be able to find it, but the 77 Wizard is the other comparable example to Plug One, and the reason is because of the exceptionally high impact. Plug One has 92, Plan C has about 90, 88 or so, and then the 77 Wizard is the highest in the game at 97, I believe. However, the 77 Wizard does not have stability this high. Now, I'm actually going to take off all my stability increasing mods. Now, that's pretty average as far as stability goes, but it just so happens that Plug One stability is very, very high. And given that, you know, it looks average for a maxed out fusion rifle when you take all of these upgrades off, you would then expect some serious payoff if you then add Perfect Balance or some other perks that increase the stability onto the weapon. And lo and behold, this becomes a perfectly stable fusion rifle. At 100% stability, you can basically take this thing, and there will be no lift from the weapon. You can see that I've used this, and I can say for a fact that this thing will be pinpoint accurate. You can use this thing to the accuracy of a sniper rifle, and that's what's so excellent about it. You can go ahead and grab this and pull this into any scenario, and it will work because of this incredible stability. And that's what I feel makes this fusion rifle so strong. Now, obviously, you're going to have to roll into the Perfect Balance perk. If you don't, then that's a big problem, because obviously, your stability is going to look a little bit more like this. That's still a decent fusion rifle, and there are some good alternatives. You can get the accelerated coils, which improves the charge rate quite significantly. You can, of course, get the enhanced battery, which increases the magazine capacity from 5 to 8. But Perfect Balance, for those of you who are looking for a true mid-range option, this right here, this impact to stability ratio means that you are almost never going to fail. And that's what's so strong about it. In particular as well, look at the perks that I've got. Spray and play is not particularly good unless you're in PvE. Having said that, if you do run a particular build, such as a Defender Titan, which has War Machine on a Disintegrate Melee, then you can go ahead and stack up your reload bonuses. It just so happens the other reload bonus is actually a very good one, Feeding Frenzy. Kills with this weapon increase the reload speed for a short time. Not bad considering that the magazine on this is smaller than other fusion rifles might be. So if you go ahead and consider that you have a triple reload bonus, potentially with Spray and Play, Feeding Frenzy, and of course, War Machine, then you can go ahead and look at this and it will literally have a melee so fast that it's under a second. 0.5, I think, is something that I've measured this to be. And if that's with reload that fast, the magazine becomes irrelevant. So Feeding Frenzy in particular is a really, really good perk because it mitigates any damage that would be done by not having the coils upgrade. In all things considered, I'd say this fusion rifle is one of the best in the game. There are lots of other kind of ways in which you can analyze that. I know the Datto in particular takes a look at fusion rifles, and if they don't have a really high charge rate, he disregards them, and that's a completely legitimate opinion. But that is an opinion that is also not considering the fact that a skilled fusion rifle player understands that they should be charged from around corners, and that using fusion rifles in a CQC environment, whilst it is viable, is not necessarily the way they're meant to be used. They're meant to be used to cut off opponents that are charging directly at you with a shotgun or a shoulder charge or just any melee ability that requires a straight line of sight to the target. They're designed to take those people out because they move when you fire them in an upwards trajectory. So take a look at that and then combine it with the fact that it can push out to these ranges, combine it with stability and the fact that you can charge it around the corner. A skilled fusion rifle user, I'd say, is far, far, far better off using these in mid-range builds, which is why, if I was going to recommend this to anyone, I'd recommend it to a Warlock or a Titan, not specifically a Hunter. The reason for that is really because of one stat, which I accidentally do not have very much spec'd into on this build. It's because of recovery. When you spec into recovery, you're going to regenerate much faster, which means that you have way, way, way more bonuses when you are standing there in cover, and your health is regenerating, you're also charging up your fusion rifle, you can generally frame the engagement this way. It does mean that you can't afford to sprint around in the Crucible. It does mean that you have to be a little bit more stationary, and I'm not saying camp, I'm saying move to an appropriate position. Make sure your enemy is always on the edge of your radar, and estimate when that person with shoulder charge or a shotgun or blink is going to come around the corner, because you never know necessarily all the time, but you can estimate to a pretty close degree of accuracy how much it's going to be. So this is why I say this fusion rifle is probably the best. I will openly say the one thing about my variant that is not brilliant is the spray and play perk. Bringing this up earlier, there are some other really strong contenders that you could have in this category. And one of my favorites actually is Rangefinder, which solves the alternate weakness of fusion rifles really, which is the range. Now, there are a few other things that you could throw on there. Obviously, you have perks like Glass Half Full that you could use to replace them. There are really good perks out there that might synergize as well. I've wondered whether Cascade might be decent or not on a fusion rifle, but at the end of the day, I think all of that is irrelevant when you compare it to the fact that this fusion rifle should be used in mid-range. All of these perks, aside from Spray and Play, amazing in mid-range, and Rangefinder improving the range of that will seriously help it to push out into an even better range. The one other perk that I might consider, if you really did want to take this weapon into CQC, in which point you would have to swap out and look for one which has accelerated coils, is if you had a hipfire perk here. And if you do have hipfire, that means that it's a much more viable weapon to take into the kind of shotgun territory, because you can beat them at their own game occasionally. You can fire it from the hip from slightly further away than shotgun ranges, and you can win. And that's a really, really important buff of having a fusion rifle. Allowing yourself to be able to fire from the hip like that is so, so vital. Especially if you have a really high stability weapon like this, it's never going to shift. It's not going to move. So if you can guarantee that your target is at the center of that reticle, you're going to kill them every single time. That's the one improvement maybe that I'd make to this particular variant. As it stands, excellent for PvE and PvP. If you have Plug One, please tell me what you think in the comments, because frankly, I think that this is amazing. And I'm surprised that this even made it into the set. A balance of stability to impact like this should not have made it in at all. The stability should have been way, way, way lower. But honestly, I'm kind of glad as well, because this helps adequately to prove a point that I've always said about fusion rifles, but has never properly been demonstrable until now. Either way, my name has been My Name Is Bife. I'll catch you guys in the next episode of Loot Drop. Parodasia Astra. I'll see you starside.